chest wall tumors, thoracic masterclass. In this lecture, a concise focused review of literature, with up-to-date diagnostic tools, and reconstructive modalities will be discussed. Chest wall tumors are a heterogeneous group of lesions that provide an interesting diagnostic and therapeutic challenge for surgeons. They make up less than 5% of thoracic malignancies and vary widely in pathology, as they arise from all anatomic structures of the chest wall. In general, treatment is wide local excision. The margins for malignant disease are necessarily wider, and adjuvant radiation is typically given for those with positive margins. Chemotherapy is rarely effective. Local control is the most important prognostic factor. Disease-free survival for malignant disease is limited by positive margins. Therefore, full oncologic resection with 4 cm margin should be attempted. The musculoskeletal structure of the chest wall serves a critical role in the protection of thoracic and mediastinal viscera, and provides integrity for respiratory function. Tumors of the chest wall can vary from benign to malignant, and arise from any soft tissue or bony structure. More than 50% of chest wall tumors are malignant, typically involving direct invasion or metastasis from adjacent thoracic tumors. Evaluation of chest wall masses, history, age. As it tends to be malignant and aggressive with age, pain, which denotes bony mass or invasion, examination for both site and size for surgical planning and reconstruction, investigations, denotes extent, invasion, metastasis, or a primary elsewhere. Clinical presentation, 20% are asymptomatic, and incidental finding on radiography, symptomatic, swelling. This might be intrathoracic or extrathoracic, pain, if present denotes either a bone mass or invasion, local invasion to the lung, mediastinum, thoracic inlet, or vertebral bodies. Symptoms of primary tumor, such as thyroid, breast lung, abdominal viscera, or prostate. Chest wall swellings should follow the classic medical teaching. It is imperative to take a proper history, analyzing the main complaint, course and duration, the presence of pain, fever and history of previous trauma. Examination should follow the usual common technique of inspection, palpation, and auscultation. The 6 cardinal signs of inspection should be followed and includes site, size, shape, surface, skin, and surrounding area. Palpation should include data for temperature, tenderness, confirm inspection findings, consistency, fluctuation, translucency, compressibility, pulsatility, mobility, and the relation to surrounding structures. Auscultation expecting Brauerian pulsatile swellings. Radiological evaluation, chest X-ray, contrast CT scan, MRI if vascular invasion or soft tissue invasion is suspected, particularly at the thoracic inlet or the mediastinum, positron emission tomography to exclude distant metastasis or a primary tumor elsewhere. Radiographic features alone are insufficient to make a complete diagnosis, and therefore histologic evaluation is required. Fine needle aspiration, incisional biopsy, or excisional biopsy are all suitable modalities to obtain a tissue diagnosis. Lesions less than 5 cm undergo excisional biopsy, and lesions greater than 5 cm may either undergo needle aspiration or incisional biopsy. This strategy is based primarily on the extent of resection and complexity of reconstruction that would need to take place, thereby making the absolute diagnosis of value prior to resection. Classification of chest wall tumors. These are broadly classified into benign and malignant. Further benign and malignant chest wall tumors are subclassified according to tissue of origin, either bony or soft tissue. Benign bony tissue tumors can arise from bone, and this includes osteoma and aneurysmal bone cysts, or arises from cartilage, and includes enchondroma, osteochondroma. All arise from fibrous tissue, and include fibrous dysplasia, the role model, and includes eosinophilic granuloma, or from vascular structures, and includes hemangioma. There is a counter malignant tumors arising from the same tissue of origin, and include osteo, Ewing, and chondrosarcomas. Malignant fibrous histiocytoma, plasmacytoma, hemangiosarcoma. Benign tumors from soft tissue includes lipoma from fat tissue, leiomyoma from muscles, neurofibroma from nerves, and desmoid from fibrous tissue. Sarcomas on the malignant scale can arise from the same tissues of origin. Benign chest wall tumors are less common than malignant lesions and arise from nerve, blood vessel, osseous, cartilaginous, or fatty tissue origin. Osteochondromas are most common in the rib or scapula, where they are commonly found at the costochondral junction, and they develop from abnormal growth of normal tissue. These masses frequently cause pain as they progress with growth of bony exostoses, wide excision for fear of malignant transformation. Chondromas are typically found at the sternocostal junction arising from cartilaginous tissue. They are relatively common, making up 15 to 20% of benign chest wall lesions. The distinction between chondroma and low-grade chondrosarcoma is difficult, therefore all chondromas are treated as malignant lesions, and wide excision is recommended. Fibrous dysplasia typically appears in the lateral or posterior tract of the ribs and is the third most frequent benign chest wall lesion. Presentation may be as an asymptomatic mass in the posterior aspect of a rib. Fibrous dysplasia appears as a lytic lesion on chest radiograph with a soap bubble or ground glass appearance that is diagnostic. Eosinophilic granuloma, or Langerhans cell histiocytosis, is a less common tumor that can arise in the anterior chest wall. Treatment is wide local excision both for diagnosis and symptomatic relief. The soft tissue tumors that affect the chest wall have a similar variability in pathology as that of the bone-based lesions. Cutaneous nevi, lipomas, hemangiomas, lymphangiomas, and neurogenic tumors are some of the benign lesions that can be found in the soft tissue of the chest wall. They are treated with wide local excision to negative margins to avoid local tissue recurrence. Intercostal hernias have also been reported that can be confused with benign soft tissue lesions, mandating appropriate radiographic confirmation of clinical suspicion based on history and physical examination. Lymphangiomas of the chest wall usually can be cystic or cavernous in nature and are a result of a developmental malformation. They can be located within the mediastinum or the chest wall itself. Preoperative CT imaging is essential to assess the extent of the lesion, as several reports of giant lesions exist in the literature. Complete surgical excision is required for excellent prognosis and avoidance of long-term lymphatic fistula formation. Non-operative therapy with radiation or sclerosing agents remains controversial for lymphangiomas of the chest wall, with surgery as the standard of care. Hemangiomas can be found within the chest wall or protruding through the chest wall from the thoracic cavities or mediastinum and arise from blood vessels. MRI is used to distinguish benign from malignant lesions based on flebulites, fat component, and high intensity and fat suppression on T2 imaging technique, but surgical biopsy is required for definitive diagnosis. Hemangiomas of the chest wall can be intramuscular, intercostal, or cavernous. They tend to occur in younger patients, 30 years of age, and present as painful masses. Treatment is complete surgical excision if symptomatic, but local recurrence rates are as high as 20%. Desmoid tumors arise from musculoapaneurotic structures and are considered myofibroblastic or fibroblastic in origin. They can develop anywhere in the body but are most common in the extremities, with only 10 to 28% arising in the chest wall. Their histology is benign, but because of their aggressive growth rates and tendency to grow into nearby structures or cause compressive symptoms, they can be considered malignant. Desmoid tumors are common in females and males usually younger than 40 years, and can be found in patients with familial adenomatous polyposis. Desmoids can also occur in sites of previous trauma, scar, or radiation. Resection to tumor-free margins is needed for cure when negative margins are not possible. Radiation should be considered. Recurrence rates for desmoid tumors are high. The reported 5-year probability of developing a local recurrence is 37%, with an 89% rate in patients who had positive margins at the time of resection. Neurogenic tumors of the chest wall include neurofibromas and neurolemmomas that arise from peripheral nerve sheaths and are usually associated with neurofibromatosis. Surgical excision is usually only recommended for cosmetic reasons for cutaneous lesions as there is a low likelihood of malignancy. However, plexiform lesions are associated with nerve roots and have a high potential to transform into malignant lesions. Plexiform lesions that are increasing in size or becoming symptomatic should be completely excised without preoperative biopsy. Malignant chest wall tumors can either be primary or secondary. The primary tumor can arise from this skeletal tissue or soft tissue. Skeletal primary malignant lesion if the chest wall accounts for 55% of all chest wall masses, have on average 5-year survival of 60%. Malignant lesion tends to grow faster, more painful, and larger than benign lesions. However, Soft tissue primary malignant lesions accounts for 6% of soft tissue sarcomas in the body. They are typically found in the middle-aged men, presents with the painless masses, except rhabdomyosarcoma, which are more common in children. Primary malignant bony chest wall tumors, chondrosarcomas are most commonly found on the anterior chest wall, and account for 30% of primary malignant bone tumors. They are the most common malignant bony tumor of the chest wall. Chondrosarcomas are rarely found in patients younger than 20 years of age, and are found more commonly in the third and fourth decades. These tumors represent a malignant degeneration of the benign chondroma, with both tumors having similar clinical presentations of painful, hard, slow-growing, fixed masses on the anterior chest wall. Additionally, they can be associated with trauma. Radiographic appearance is typically a poorly defined mass associated with cortical distraction, and CT usually delineates a lobulated mass of soft tissue attenuation with dense chondroid matrix calcification. Synchronous or metachronous lung metastases are seen in 10% of patients at the time of presentation. Pathologic distinction between chondroma and chondrosarcoma is challenging, therefore both tumors are resected with 4 cm margins. Resection is the mainstay of therapy, chemotherapy is largely ineffective, and radiation is reserved for patients who are unresectable or with positive resection margins. 5-year survival is 65-92%. Tumor-free margin is the largest predictor of local recurrence. 10% of patients with negative margins will have local recurrence, whereas 75% of those with positive margins will have local recurrence. Osteosarcomas make up 10-15% of malignant chest wall tumors, commonly occurring in the rib, scapula, and clavicles. These tumors present as painful masses in young or elderly adults. Metastatic disease at the time of presentation is common, with the most common sites being lung, lymph nodes, and liver. The mass appears calcified on imaging with lytic or sclerotic osteoid bone matrix in the mass. Treatment is wide local excision in combination with chemotherapy. The presence of metastases drastically affects 5-year survival, decreasing it from more than 50% to between 15-20%. Response to chemotherapy, tumor burden, and presence of metastases are predictive of overall survival. The Ewing sarcoma group of tumors is a spectrum of small round cell tumors, including Ewing sarcoma, Askin tumor of the chest wall, and primitive neuroctodermal tumor. These tumors are the third most common malignant chest wall tumors overall, but are the most common in the pediatric and young adult populations. The Ewing sarcoma family is an aggressive tumor family with high recurrence rates and high likelihood of metastasis. Neoadjuvant chemotherapy is typically given, followed by wide local excision with good results. Response to chemotherapy is predictive of local recurrence. Metastasis reduce 5-year survival to 30% from 100% with local disease at presentation. Solitary plasmacytoma is a rare tumor composed of monoclonal plasma cells, as in multiple myeloma. However, this is a discrete mass without diffuse spread. This tumor affects elderly men who present with pain without a mass. Once surgical biopsy has been performed, surgical therapy stops because this tumor is treated primarily with radiation. 5-year survival is 40-60%, and overall survival is dependent on whether or not multiple myeloma develops, and not on control of the primary lesion. Primary soft tissue chest wall tumors, malignant fibrous histiocytomas are found in the chest wall, but are very common throughout the body, most commonly in the extremities, abdomen, or retroperitoneum. It is commonly found in elderly men, and there is usually a history of previous chest wall radiation. The masses can grow to be a large size, but are usually not painful. It has a heterogeneous appearance on CT that can be enhancing or calcified. Treatment is wide local excision, and local recurrence rates are higher than 30%. Metastatic lesions are diagnosed in 30-50% of patients, and 5-year survival is only 38%. Liposarcomas are one of the most common malignant soft tissue tumors in the body, but they are not common in the chest wall. They are rarely found in children, and are most common in men ages 40-60 years. It is not unusual for them to be large and frequently associated with trauma. Treatment is wide local excision, and 5-year survival is 60%. Local recurrence rates are high, and there is little to no role for chemotherapy and radiation. Neurofibrosarcomas are typically associated with neurofibromatosis, and grow along intercostal nerves. They usually affect men in the third and fourth decades of life. who present with painful masses, treatment is with wide local excision and postoperative radiation regardless of surgical margins. Currently, 5-year survival is 55%. Angiosarcoma of the chest wall is a rare vascular tumor that occurs in adults and is associated with chronic lymphedema, irradiation, and chemical exposure. The most common clinical presentation of angiosarcoma of the chest wall is after radiation therapy for breast conservation therapy after breast cancer. Patients commonly present 5 to 10 years after radiation therapy, and 5-year survival after diagnosis is only 16%. Wide local excision is the only option for therapy, as most patients cannot have more radiation, and chemotherapy is usually ineffective. Metastatic lesions of the chest wall, Jess wall, and sternal resection for metastatic cancer is associated with relief of pain, ulceration, and bleeding caused by disease recurrence, although such cases are stage 4 for primary is in the breasts, colon, prostate. In the current era, emerging hormonal and biological protocols have greatly impacted the survival of what was considered lethal in the past. Currently, reconstructive chest wall resection has gained popularity in these cases, particularly the carry low morbidity and mortality. Principles of chest wall resection and reconstruction. Chest wall resection is the primary treatment modality for chest wall masses. If the tumors are chemosensitive, like in osteosarcoma, rhabdomyosarcoma, Ewing sarcoma, and other small cell sarcomas should be treated with chemotherapy in a neoadjuvant setting, then continued postoperatively depending on tumor response. Chondrosarcoma are primary treated with surgical resection and a 4 cm safety margin. However, if this cannot be achieved, radiotherapy is given postoperatively. Principles of chest wall resection and construction. Oncological margin should not be a concern over chest wall defects. The principles for reconstruction to maintain chest wall integrity and intrathoracic protection include: reconstruction is not needed if the defect are less than 5 cm or posteriorly located and covered by the scapula. Skeletal stabilization is achieved with autologous tissue, mesh, Gore-Tex, or methylmethacrylate sandwich reconstruction. Soft tissue reconstruction can be performed using myocutaneous or omental flaps. To be continued, materials and techniques in chest wall reconstruction.